word parasite is derived from the Greek parasitos, with para meaning alongside, and sitos, which translates as food. A parasite is an organism that lives within another organism called a host, and depends on it for its survival. It uses the host's resources to fuel its life cycle. As certain types of parasites gain strength, they may weaken and even compromise the lives of the organisms they feed on. Some can even multiply within their hosts or continue to live inside them for years. There are numerous types of parasitic relationships in nature, and even though a number of these organisms don't typically kill their hosts, some may cause and spread infectious diseases, which can often be fatal. There are more than 1,000 known parasite species that can infect humans. Around 70% of them are microscopic in size, aside from certain worm parasites that can reach incredible lengths of several feet. Number 5, flesh-eating parasite. I was so sick and I was in so much pain, burning feet, burning face, almost like an acid burning. This is how teenager Carly Goff described the 6 years of her life that she spent with a flesh-eating parasite feeding on her insides. While on holiday with her family in Fiji, the girl ate fish contaminated with a parasitic roundworm called Gnathostoma. From that point on, her life was pretty much hell. The roundworm has teeth and keeps chewing through muscle and tissue, destroying everything as it goes. Once doctors finally determined that she'd been infected with the parasite, they gave her a worm tablet, which progressively starved it. Humans have known about certain parasites, such as tapeworms and roundworms, since ancient times, and the first microscopic observations occurred in the 17th century. There are three main classes of parasites known to cause disease in humans. These are protozoa, helminths, and ectoparasites. Protozoa are microscopic single-cell organisms able to multiply within the host. Helminths are multicellular worm parasites, which are generally visible to the naked eye in their adult stages. Ectoparasites typically live on the host rather than inside it and include ticks, lice, fleas, mites, and, in a broader definition, even mosquitoes, which need the blood of their hosts to survive. Perhaps the scariest thing about parasites is that they're found everywhere. Those that enter our body usually do so through the mouth or skin, and may live in various parts of the body, including the skin, heart, liver, or intestines, and even the brain. Some are so small that they may become airborne and carried by the wind, meaning that they can be in the very air we breathe. Certain mosquitoes, fleas, or flies are known to carry parasites. Malaria, for example, is caused by a parasite called Plasmodium, transmitted by the anopheles mosquito. Roundworms, ringworms, or tapeworms, and other parasites may be transmitted to humans from contact with pets such as cats or dogs. Many parasites live in human or animal feces and may contaminate food or water. Some ectoparasites may be transmitted through sexual or skin-to-skin contact, as well as sharing clothing or bedding. Number 4, flatworm bladder infection. After becoming infected with a type of flatworm called Schistosoma, a 43-year-old man from Qatar started to feel pain when urinating and noticed blood in his urine. It took over a month for doctors to diagnose him with the infection. Eggs from the parasite transmitted by freshwater snails made their way near his bladder and ureters, the tubes which connect the bladder to the kidneys. The body's immune response had caused areas of the bladder wall to become calcified in a pattern called eggshell calcification. Doctors were stunned to discover his bladder encased in calcium, as it normally takes years for such a buildup. Afterwards, they discovered he'd contracted the parasite as a child. He'd literally lived with it in his body for over 30 years before a treatment was prescribed. It's been theorized that parasites have killed more people than all of humanity's wars combined. They're incredibly apt at surviving and can live inside the body for extended periods of time. They're also hard to detect and treat, and the effects of parasite infections range from mild discomfort to death. While some of them, such as Plasmodium, cause disease directly, others cause disease by secreting toxins. Protozoa parasites multiply at a fast rate, and some of them may feed on the calcium linings of our bones or even the protein coating of our nerves, disrupting impulses to the brain. Trypanosoma brucei is a protozoa transmitted by sets of fly bites that cause African sleeping sickness, which can be fatal. Malaria, caused by Plasmodium, kills more than 700,000 people worldwide each year, many of them children living in sub-Saharan Africa. In fact, most parasite victims are found in developing countries. Around 740 million people in these regions are affected each year by hookworm infections. Although rarely lethal, in children, these can lead to impaired physical and intellectual development. In pregnant women, hookworm infections increase the risk of death, both for them and their babies. However, these aren't the creepiest parasites. Larvae from Tanea solium, also known as the pork tapeworm, can find their way to the brain and the central nervous system, where they form cysts. And they're not the only parasites which favor the human brain. MRI scans of a British man taken in 2014 discovered a 0.4-inch tapeworm called Spirometra irinachiropi, still alive and moving inside his brain. What's even more disturbing is that the man had been visiting doctors with symptoms such as seizures, headaches, and memory loss since 2008. Number 3. Giant parasite. An unnamed man from Singapore stunned doctors when they discovered a 9-foot tapeworm living inside his intestine. The man was amazed, as he hadn't experienced any of the symptoms normally associated with tapeworm infection, such as fatigue, constipation, or abdominal pain. The long and thin parasite was pulled out of the patient's rectum and had to be folded several times before a picture of it could be taken. It is unclear how he got the infection, but experts from the Singapore General Hospital's Department of Microbiology believe it had something to do with ingesting raw fish. Sushi and sashimi are raw dishes that may contain tapeworm larvae. When a fish eats tapeworm eggs, the larvae hatch and attach themselves to its intestinal wall, thus contaminating the flesh. The tapeworm can grow in the human body to lengths over 50 feet. It can go undetected and survive for years while releasing its own eggs and infecting other parts of the body. Number 2. Yin Meng. 29-year-old Yin Meng had been complaining of headaches and suffering from seizures for 6 years before doctors found the source of her symptoms. After collapsing at work, she was rushed to hospital in China's Yunnan province, where doctors discovered something growing inside her brain. Not knowing what it was or how to remove it, the doctors sent her home. Meng started taking medication to control the symptoms. As her condition worsened, Meng's boyfriend took her to the hospital once more. This time, the surgeons agreed to perform the risky operation. They removed a 4-inch tapeworm that had attached itself to her central nervous system. The parasitic infection she'd been suffering from was called sparagonosis, caused by larvae from the Spirometra or Diphyllobothrium parasites, One of the ways the infection is transmitted is through contaminated water or the ingestion of a carrier such as a snake or a frog. As she woke from the operation and was told more about her condition, Meng realized where she might have gotten the infection from. She recalled that as a child, when she was around 5 years old, she would catch and eat live frogs with her grandmother. Symptoms of parasitic infection may include abdominal pain, aching joints or muscles, allergies, weight loss, increased appetite, anxiety, fatigue, nervousness, vomiting, or diarrhea. It's worth mentioning, however, that these symptoms can mimic anemia or hormone deficiency and may be confused with pneumonia or food poisoning. As it is the case with many diseases, prevention is the best medicine. This means practicing safe sex, maintaining proper hygiene, washing fruit and vegetables, not eating undercooked meat, and making sure the water you drink is clean, as well as taking the necessary precautions when traveling to countries known for diseases caused by parasites. There are a number of anti-parasitic drugs developed that destroy the parasitic agents or inhibiting their growth. These are usually effective against a limited number of parasites within a particular class. Number 1. Eddie Zeitner and Kacey Stevens. After a holiday in the Caribbean, a Canadian couple returned home with itchy feet that later began showing painful swelling and blisters. 25-year-old Eddie Zeitner and girlfriend 22-year-old Kacey Stevens started noticing symptoms after walking barefoot on the beaches of Punta Cana in the Dominican Republic. After returning to Ontario, the pain got so bad that they couldn't wear shoes anymore and had to rely on crutches to walk. They decided to seek medical help. They were shocked and terrified when doctors explained that they had dozens of hookworm larvae living inside their feet. The parasites typically live in the intestines of cats, dogs, and other wild animals and may enter the human skin through soil or sand that's been contaminated with feces. As Zeitner and Stevens were walking barefoot on the beach, the parasites burrowed their way through the skin on their feet. Fortunately, the couple managed to get proper treatment. They posted their experience on Facebook in an attempt to warn fellow travelers.
Realizing the situation, observers on the boat above opened the cage's escape hatch to provide an escape route for the creature. Chan, on the other hand, dived down and slipped out of the bottom of the cage to escape. However, he discovered two other sharks swimming close by beneath him. Not wanting to become prey to the pair, he quickly swam back up.